Ahoy, this is Zdenka. Not you again.
Ahoy. Hello.
This is a madness. Stop. How did I do all this? 3D green screen tutorial coming up. This video is sponsored by Epidemic Sound. What you just saw might look complicated, but in reality, it's not really that complicated. What is complicated is to come with the idea, with the concept, and film those little bits and pieces. You don't want to forget any of those bits and pieces. And you have to fill them well, and then put the whole puzzle together. You can use this type of entertainment in any kind of video. Imagine you're making a cooking recipe and suddenly the ingredients start flying by, or you are maybe having a tools popping up on the screen as you're explaining how to fix something. I think we can all use a good laugh, right? What you're going to need is the actual green screen. I've got this oval one. I'm gonna link it below for those interested. It's kind of big. Just to give you a heads up, it's difficult to fold. Well, it's a pain. But if you need something bigger, better choice would be to get the actual background. You can get a fabric, a green screen, or you can get a paper roll. I also have these green sheets of paper for small objects. You know, like you can put a spinner and the object on a spinner, then you can spin it, or you can hang it with the help of the fishing string or wire, whatever you call it. Hey, I think they understand, right? To light up the green screen is very simple, but you have to be very consistent with the light. Meaning that when I was filming this studio or mini-me or the objects, the light, the main light, was always on this side. If I was recording an object and the main light would be on this side and then on that side in the front, it would be a big mess. You have to always make sure that the main light is coming from the same side. If you have lots of headroom, you can just place one light from the top to light the whole background, the whole green screen. I don't have such a high ceiling, so I placed one light on one side and second on the other side. I look through the camera if it looks evenly lit, it's not overlit, and that's all. I wasn't standing too close to the background because I didn't want the green screen to spill on me. You need to have the object as far as you can from the green screen. Then I just placed the main light in front of me and finished. To create this whole madness, I had to film bits and pieces. All started with recording this whole studio. So I set up all the lights, and first, just with a camera, I recorded just the background without me. You don't even have to record a whole video, just a little video, and then you take the frame out, you make a photo, you place that photo on a timeline, and you stretch it as long as you need it. That way you will save a lot of space. Next step would be recording myself here in the studio with the green screen behind me. I recorded only those bits and pieces where those little things were popping up on the side here. When I was actually grabbing the mosquito thing, this one, this is how we kill mosquitoes here in Canada. We play tennis nonstop. So when I was grabbing this, I cut it again to this studio setup. No more green screen, because when I was moving it out like this, I was already moving it out of the frame. It was out of the green screen. So you have to really pay attention to your movement and how you are stretching it out of the green screen. That's why I said the white green screen is way better. Another step would be recording myself standing up, and I was actually using here also the green sheets when I was reaching out, something reaching down. I placed it right in front of me. Lastly, I took photo of all the gear on the white background. If I wanted the video, I would have to do it on a green screen, but I just optioned for photos. Before I dive in into all the layers to build the whole scene, let's start with the simple one, and that will be adding the mini me. Yeah, that mini person right there. I use Adobe Premiere Pro as an editing software, but you can do this with any editing software. For example, Filmora has it under chroma key. By the way, I'm gonna be creating a tutorial how to edit video for beginners in Filmora. So subscribe if you're not subscribed already. Now I'm in the Adobe Premiere Pro. I placed the main clip on a timeline and the green screen clip above it. I created another layer Let's work with that green screen clip now. Go to effects, type in Ultra Key, drag the effect on the selected clip. With a color picker, you are going to select the green. Background should be removed, and then you just drag the sliders to clean it up. Here are exactly the values I selected to clean it up. Transparency, 40, tolerance, 100, pedestal, 50, choke, 10, soften, 10, contrast, 10, midpoint, 50. Underspill suppression, desaturate, range, spill, and luma, everything is 50. Color correction, saturation, and luminance is 100. Now you just resize the clip and position it where you exactly want it. To make it really pop, I added this transition effect. Now you can just have it pop on the screen, but I wanted something different, something a little, you know, just extra, a little shimmer, a little cartoony. Under effects, look for VR light leaks and just drag it on the beginning of the clip and drag it on the end of the clip. That's all there is to it. Simple. Visually, it looks all great, but what really makes it complete are the little sound effects. As many as possible, whenever objects appear or disappear or pops or zoom by, as many sound effects as possible. There's a twist to it. Don't just drag the sound effect there and leave it as it is. Listen to it and adjust the volume. You don't want them too much to overpower what you're saying or the music. Some of them can be louder, some of them should be quieter, just so it is there. I found all the sound effects in Epidemic Sound Library I used for a number of years. I just clicked on the sound effects and went into the cartoon collection. Literally everything was there I was looking for. Epidemic Sound gives you access to a massive library. They own 100% of the music, so you don't have to worry that you receive a copyright strike or takedown. And of course, you can use it on monetized channels as well. You can use it on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and more. The whole list is on their website. You can download full songs or separate stems. Just beats, just a melody, just vocals. The options are endless. You can choose between personal and commercial plans. Like I said, I've been with Epidemic Sound for a number of years and they always have fresh music. If you sign up to Epidemic Sound by using my link below the video in the video description, you will receive a free 1 month trial. Any music you will use during the trial will remain safe and protected, even if you cancel your subscription after your trial month is over. Thank you very much, Epidemic Sound, for making this video possible. How did I make all the gear flying across the screen? I took photos of the gear on the white background. Then in Photoshop, I removed the background with literally one click. Select the background and hit delete, save as PNG file. I just dragged those objects on the middle layer between the studio clip of the background and me sitting on the green screen in the front and created the movement from side to side. When I had the objects fly behind me to make it more realistic, I sized them down as they were going behind me to create a depth. The opposite, when I had the objects come from behind me to the front, I zoomed on them. I had them bigger as they were going to the side. One more effect is left out. How did I have myself coming off the frame on the white? I went on YouTube to watch any of my random videos and took a screenshot. Press Windows button, Shift and S. Then you drag and select the area you want. Now it's copied. Open up Photoshop and just paste it. I erased the name of the video so it's just neutral. All that was left to do was to bring it to Adobe Premiere Pro. Align the frame of the frame with the frame right here. Drag clip over this and simply create a zoom effect of both clips at the same time. Zoom out and zoom in again. When it is zoomed out, you have another playground for placing another objects or people on the white edges over it. Once you know how to remove the green background, the green screen on the clip, you are all set. The rest is just figuring out all the layers, positioning of the clips, little transitions, a lot of sound effects. That's all. Again, the main thing is to figure out the whole idea, the whole story, how to act, where to look, all the things flying by. You gotta jot it down, you gotta write it down on the paper, plan it a little bit ahead. It can be very entertaining. It can be a lot of fun. It's actually a lot of fun to make, especially now when the weather is super cold and you cannot really go outside to film. Perfect activity to do right now. Give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more. If you have any questions, comments, simply want to say hi, leave it below. And I'll see you in the next video. Ciao, ahoy.